Good morning, students. Today we are continuing the last topic what I have started, that is the lesson, the journey. And here is how I have said you that how it began, how the lesson began. The writer said that after spending a leisurely Sunday at home, the very thought of returning to work on Monday is tiring. And as we discussed, that author was a government officer and he came to get married. He got married. After getting married, he is returning to his workplace. And his education made him not to carry the luggage. He had a small trunk. I have said you what is a trunk. It's a small wooden or metallic box where you can keep your belongings or things. So that is the thing. And he says that finally, you know, father came came up with a solution. That he said that I will carry the luggage to Dirang. Dirang is a place where is a place of bus stop, and that's a place actually. And there is a bus stop, and nearly, you know, many kilometers they have to walk from their village to that bus stop, that to that place called Dirang. And but this man protested. He said that father, do not carry it. I mean, how could I allow my father to carry the luggage? And he is old, and I know I am young. But still, he says that. How could I even carry the luggage, because you know I am a government officer and what the people would think of me. So that was the thing. But finally, however, father decided that he will carry the luggage, and last that we have discussed in the class. So let us continue. Here a large crowd gathered at our place, and the day I was to leave, you can see here this paragraph. So here he left a large crowd gathered at his home to say him, to bid him goodbye. And he left for Dirang at 10:20. And his father had already left him, and he has to do a catching up. I mean, catching up is nothing but he has to move fast, he has to walk fast to reach somebody. You are coming something from behind or walking very fast to reach that person is called as catching up. Suppose already somebody has left, now you are going and you are chasing them and you are catching them, or you are, you know, meeting them. So that is called as catching up. So he says that I had to catch up my father, and nearly 3 kilometers down the road, okay, I caught up with my father. That means he had walked 3 kilometers to catch his father, to catch up his father. And when he walked 3 kilometers, actually usually he won't walk 3 kilometers or 4 kilometers, because he is a government officer. He sits and works, okay, he has a white collar job, you can say. But here he had to walk 3 kilometers to catch up his father. And when he reached his father, he was already tired, almost all tired. And see what has happened, let us see. He says that having walked fast, I was tired. Moreover, I had to cross 2 hills on the way up to the spot. I quickly sat down on a rock. My father laughed at my plight. So when he reached his father, you know, laughed at the sad condition, you know, undesirable plight is nothing but undesirable situation, or, you know, very sad situation is called as plight. So by seeing that his son is very much tired and are just walking 3 kilometers, so that is not in the case with of his father. You know, father is, you know, he lives in a village, he works in the field, so he was not so tired. He walked nearly, he usually walks 3 to 4 kilometers or 5 kilometers, so that is not a big deal for his father, but to him it is a very big deal. So that's why nowadays also, you know, we can't walk nearly 3 or 4 kilometers from our house, and for small distance we use bikes or, you know, cycles and all that. So that is why here you see he was very tired, and father laughed by seeing his young son that he was so tired. And so this little, he also said that, so this little distance has tired you, he said. And rest for a while, they started resting. And here is the picture. They sat down near a tree. And after a long time, you know, father didn't say anything. And father was a little bit shy of speaking to his son, okay, asking anything to his son, because what would the son think? Okay, that was the human relation that is being shown in this lesson. That father was quiet for some time, and after a while he asked, he said that actually he didn't like to ask his son anything, but letting, after that he was feeling very thirsty, then he said that wetting his lips with his tongue, he said, in a, as a matter of fact, I am thirsty. Then father finally asked, though he was thirsty, he wasn't asking anything. But later he could not stop himself and said that, son, I am thirsty. Then as soon as the son heard, okay, he gave him the can of wine which he brought, and the father himself poured in a mug, and he drank in all one go, okay, at a time he drank, okay, that mug mug full of wine. Okay, and wine is nothing but it's just a type of a, you know, palm wine or a juice, something which is usually you can find in the villages. Okay, this is the common thing. Okay, and he then arranged the belt that was attached to a trunk carefully on his forehead. Again, the journey started, and the father carried the luggage and the trunk, the belt of the trunk. Okay, the belt of the trunk he just hung him near the forehead. I mean, caught it near the forehead. Okay, arranged it near the forehead, and started moving. Okay, both of them started walking together. Now the journey begins, and now from there they are moving towards the Dirang, to the bus stop, where the bus stop is situated, and where from where Arthur has to catch a bus and has to go to his workplace. So that's the thing. And he says that both of them started walking. They walked long distance, they walked many kilometers, but both of them did not speak a word. They didn't speak even a word. And moreover, son was very young. Okay, he just got married. He has just got married. But the father was carrying the luggage. Son would like to ask, I mean, he was thinking that I should say my father that, father, give me the luggage, I will carry. But this self-conscious had probably to do with my education. I mean, he says that my self-conscious in the sense something kind of, you know, feeling a type of guilt or shame. Okay, so that's the thing, pride, little bit pride, that is called as self-conscious. He says that my self-conscious did not allow me to ask my father that let me give father, I will carry the luggage, give me, hand over the luggage to me. So he says that that he had a feeling, and moreover he also thought that if I carry the luggage, the what would people think of me? The whole world will laugh at me, and I would be belittled. That means, suppose if he asked his father, give me, the situation is, he is not in a position to ask his father to give the luggage. And he didn't like his father to carry the luggage. So he's in, you know, dilemma. You can say that he's not ready to allow his father to carry the luggage, and he himself is not ready to carry the luggage. But what to do? Somebody should carry the luggage. So that's why father is carrying the luggage. Okay. So what do you think? See here, if you are in the place of author, what would you do? Okay, if you are in the place of author, what would you do? Would you allow your father to carry the luggage, or will you carry the luggage? Okay, so if you are young and if your father is very old, so what would you do if you are in the place of this author? Okay, so that's the thing. And you are an educated man, you are a government officer, and you are walking on the road, and and you think that is a kind of a trunk or a box, okay, that you have to carry. So what would you do if you are in the place of author? Think and answer. Okay, so here he says that I would be belittled in the sense seem less important. Somebody see you as a less important, okay, small or less important. So that's why I think that is called as belittled. And I would be belittled if I carry the luggage, he thought in that way. And father also wanted to say many things, but father didn't say anything. And thinking that son might feel, okay, or many things are there. In in the families, you can see that father and son won't speak to each other a lot. Okay, so that's a case here. And the father had, and for this writer is thinking, is saying that father had provided for my education, and I had been able to realize his dream. They gave everything to me, and I fulfilled their dreams, and because of me they are able to earn the greater admiration in the village. That means because of me, even the villagers respect my family members, and my family members are very happy with me, and that is why if I carry the trunk, my father would not like this one. Okay, if I take the trunk also, and my father will not see me carrying the luggage, so that is why he is carrying the luggage. And that's what, they could not see me hurt. He said that they couldn't see me hurt, okay, if I carry the luggage, or if I take something. So that's the thing. I concluded that it would be better let him carry the luggage. So that is why finally he was quiet and said that father will carry the luggage. And that is what, and he was more stronger, and moreover he says that my father is a very strong person because he works in the field, and on the other hand I never got used of physical labor because I never carried such a trunk or luggage. I was not habituated to this kind of things. In spite of my youth and strength, I was physically useless. In spite of my youth and
strength. I was physically useless, he said. I continued walking silently with my father. Narrator says that I continued with my father, and after resting it at more two places, after walking a long distance, after walking many kilometers, finally they reached a place called Dirang. Okay, and the bus from Tawang had not reached Dirang, so we had some time in hand. So that means the bus didn't come, and they have to wait at the bus stop. So from where the bus is coming? From Tawang. And where he has to go? From to Bomdila. Bomdila is a place, and he has to go to Bomdila. But presently they are at Dirang, and they are waiting for the bus. And the bus is coming from the place called Tawang. And where they have to go? They have to go to a place called Bomdila, where Arthur works, and from there the author journeys continue. Okay, so that's the thing. And there was a small tea shop near the bus stop, and they entered into the tea shop, and they both of them sat facing each other. I mean, the father and the son sat in the tea shop facing each other, and father was a little bit tired because he was carrying the luggage, and he sat, and they ordered the tea, and the waiter brought the tea, and both of them started taking, and writer says that I was going to take my first sip, I heard my father's voice. Do you have a pair of old shoes? The father asked. As the writer is going to take a first sip, the father asked him something, saying that, do you have a pair of old shoes? So here the father is asking that, my son, do you have a pair of old shoes? The father isn't asking even a money or something to buy a new shoe, but here you see how is the relationship here. The father is asking old pair of shoes. Okay, so that's the thing. And then writer says that, why I asked? And then writer, I mean even the narrator, the author, he said that, why father, what is the reason? Okay, then he said that the road is uneven and full of pebbles. Pebbles mean the sense small stones, and it is a pebbles driven road. You know, pebble in the sense pebbles, stones, small stones are scattered on the way, so that is why a lot of hilly areas. How are the hilly? No proper road. There is a non-motorable road, that is non-motorable road. So that is why it hurts while walking. And when this man saw the father's feet, he was shocked that it has grown up to a size. I mean, he's saying that it is resembling those of an elephant. Feet is looking just like an, it has swollen, and it is similar to that of an elephant's leg. So he was so shocked to see, and he was surprised, and he was feeling a lot of guilt and shame, because the father did not say anything on the way that this writer is walking wearing the shoe, okay, and wearing the shoe, and his father walked barefoot without even any chappal or without shoe. He walked, and moreover he carried the trunk many kilometers on the pebble striven road, on the road which you can spines, thorns, even spines and thorns, or small stones you can find. So his father carried the luggage, and he walked many kilometers because of his son. Okay, he want to help his son. So after a long time, he wanted to ask his son an old pair of shoes. So he asked it, but immediately father also, this narrator also felt so shocked, and he took out immediately his purse, and he gave there was 40 rupees in his pocket, and so he gave some money. That means a pair of canvas shoes would cost around 12, so the remaining amount would be enough for me to get to Bomdila. So that means he gave some money to his father, nearly 12 rupees or something he gave to his father, and said that the remaining he kept. Total out of 40, he gave 12 rupees to his father to buy a pair of shoes. He said that, no father, no old, you are see your feet, and you just buy a new pair of shoes, he said, and he gave the money to his father, and he was so sorry for his father, but he couldn't say anything, though he was feeling the pain as his father feels, but he couldn't say anything. And moreover, on the way, he even did not look at the feet of his father, that his father is a bare feet. I mean, he didn't even realize that his father is walking, and even the father didn't say anything. That is how the relationship is between the father and the son. And finally, the son sat in the bus and started his journey towards his place, and the father again looking back on the same pebble striven road, and he has to walk many kilometers, and that too with a bare feet. Now again he has to walk. Okay, so that is the journey. Okay, see how is the journey of his father and how is the journey of his son. Okay, that is a question. Okay, even in the on the road or in the life. So you can see that is what the writer wants us to think. Okay, this is what the lesson is, the journey. Okay, if you have any doubts, message me in the group. Okay, still we can discuss.